Hello, Nora.
Beautiful ladies on YouTube and Facebook. God bless you. I'm so excited to be here with you guys here tonight. I'm excited because tonight we're going to be learning a very important topic, and it is how to stay motivated in every single area of your life. So I'm really happy. I'm greeting my people here on Instagram. I see Norma, I see Karen, I see Janwa. God bless you all. I see Jeannie, who is connecting now, and I also hear my people here on YouTube and Facebook. Jessie's connecting, and all the people who are connecting. Bella, hi. I love you guys. I'm so excited to have you here. And for those who are connecting just now, remember we're studying the book, The Virtuous Woman of Today, and we're starting tonight chapter 2, which is how to stay motivated. So let's get started. Once again, welcome every single one of you who are connecting tonight or who are watching this live later. Welcome. I'm really happy to have you here. And for those of you who don't know me, my name is Diana Bryant, and I'm a Christian life coach, and I absolutely love and my passion is to help women all over the world transform their life with God's word and become everything He has called us to be. Amen. So I'm very excited about being here once again, guys. And I want to ask you, ladies, since you guys are here already, to start giving it a like and heart to this video and start sharing it with other people. Let's invite other women to be part of this sessions where we're gonna be learning how to become those virtuous women of today. And also, I'm gonna ask you to turn on your notifications on Instagram, on Facebook, on YouTube, so you guys get an alert when these lives are, when we're going live, and you guys know all the information that I'm gonna be sending you guys when the classes go live, things like that. So make sure you guys turn on your notifications. Okay, so let's start with today's topic. Once again, we're gonna be learning how to stay motivated. We're gonna learn steps, we're gonna learn a lot of things, so pay attention. I hope you guys have your notebooks, your Bible, and everything ready, your book if you have it ready, so we can study it tonight, okay? And before we get started, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much, Lord, for this opportunity you give us to study your word, to go deeper, Father, to become everything you have created us to be. Thank you, Father, for every single lady who is connecting right now. Thank you for all the ones that are going to be watching this life stream later on. Father, I ask you to please help us become the virtuous woman that you're calling us to be, to help us stay motivated to achieve every single goal and desire and dream you have placed in our hearts. Thank you, Lord, and we ask you and we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. So let's get started, ladies, tonight. Before we start, I want to go back a little bit on what we were studying last week. Just a little summary so we can remember, because all these lessons are going to be tied in together. As you guys know, the book talks about this virtuous woman being like a puzzle piece, that you need to put together all those puzzle pieces to be able to, at the end, see this virtuous woman. So today we're gonna learn that second piece of the puzzle. But one piece cannot function without the other. The puzzle cannot be completed one piece without the other. So that's why I want to always go back and kind of very quickly summarize what we have been learning. And what we learned in the first piece of the puzzle was to be a woman of good habits. So learn how to have good habits in our life. And we learned that one of the secrets of the virtuous woman to be successful at everything she did was to precisely create good daily habits in her life. And that's what we're aiming to do. We were also discussing that the enemy uses bad habits to distract us from everything that God is calling us to do. And that's why it is so important to replace bad habits with good habits in our life. We also talk about that one of the secrets to develop those good habits in our life is to actually be disciplined. And I encourage you, ladies, to start saying every single day that you're a disciplined woman. And as a matter of fact, right now, wherever you are, we're gonna type in I'm a disciplined woman. Let's go typing in the comments, I'm a disciplined woman. We're gonna repeat it and we're gonna declare it as many times as we can, because the enemy tries to make us believe that we are not disciplined, that we're not able to achieve everything that God calls us to do. And that's why we have to consistently repeat and declare that we are disciplined. So my ladies on Facebook, on YouTube, let's start typing in on Instagram, I'm a disciplined woman, and let's declare it every single day. Now we talk about also that two routines that will completely transform your life, and that it actually transformed my own life, is to have a morning routine and a night routine. And the reason why is because when you have that morning routine and you have that night routine, you're able to start and end your day right. So that's why it is important that you guys create those good habits in the morning, those good habits at night, so you guys can build that morning and night routine. That's gonna set you up to have good habits throughout your day. So we also discuss five steps, and I give you five steps that you can take to create good habits in your life. And those five steps was: step number one, identify the areas of your life where you want to incorporate good habits. So it's important to, and we went over all those areas of our life that we have. I gave you eight of them. They are in the book, or you can go and watch the videos, they're all recorded, and I show you what are those eight areas of our life. And it is important that we create good habits in each of those areas. But the first step is to identify what are those bad habits that are distracting us from achieving what we want to achieve in every single one of those areas, and then replace them with good habits. Now, step two that I gave you is to be clear and specific about the habit you want to develop and write it down. I told you that it was important that you guys, once you have that good habit, to write it down and be very specific about it. It's the only way that we can actually stay focused, if we're clear about ourselves, about what direction it is that we're taking. Step three, I told you to start working on those habits immediately, to not procrastinate, because the moment we procrastinate, we start postponing and we start forgetting about that beautiful result we're gonna get from incorporating those good habits in our life. That's why it is important that you guys take immediate action. And finally, step five that I gave you was to find support and educate. No, I'm sorry, this is the step number four, to find support and educate the people around you about the new habit. So it's important that you actually educate yourself, and I was encouraging you to find somebody who has been there, done that, somebody who already knows how to get whatever it is that you want to achieve done, and learn from that person, right? And also to educate the people that are around you, people that live with you, that you let them know what your goal is, what is that good habit you want to incorporate, so they can actually support you during the process. And the final step that I gave you was to maintain your good habits for 21 days. And I was explaining to you that as long as you do it every single day, at the same time, your brain will start registering that is something critical to do, and it's something that your own body will align with you to help you achieve that dream. So that's why it is important that you guys maintain it for at least 21 days, and you keep doing it every single day. Amen. So I also told you that there are going to be moments that you feel discouraged, that you're going to feel like you want to quit, that you don't want to advance with those good habits, because obviously you're going to face resistance. But what I was telling you is to remember, and I give you a scripture, and I'm going to read it now, that is going to help you during those moments, that it personally helps me during those moments. And it's 2 Timothy 1:7. And this scripture says, "For the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline." So it was telling us that we are self-disciplined women, that it is in us already to achieve those dreams, to achieve those goals, those things that God is calling us to do, to be able to implement those good habits in our life. So I want you to type in right now, wherever you are, "I'm a self-disciplined self-disciplined woman. I'm a self-disciplined woman. Just declare it, say it again. I know you guys have been saying it all this time that I have been teaching you, but I want to emphasize the importance of start declaring that you are disciplined, because it is in you. And when we're gonna learn today that when there is no motivation in our life, the thing that helps us is the self-discipline. Is knowing that no matter what, I already made up my mind, I want to do this in my life, I'm gonna achieve this in my life, and that self-discipline that is in us, that power that we just read from 2 Timothy, is what is going to help us achieve that goal and create those good habits in our life. Amen. So let's write down, once again, I'm a self-disciplined woman, and we're going to believe that it's in us, is a trait that the Lord has given us, and it's in you to be able to achieve all those dreams that He's calling you to do. Amen. So that was very quickly a summary of what we have learned this past 2 weeks with chapter number 1, which is Become a Woman of Habits. And we're going to start today with the second piece of the puzzle. And I'm very excited because, as I told you, little by little, we start putting together that puzzle to become that virtuous woman of today. And the more pieces that you put together, the easier it becomes. So in one piece of the puzzle always is gonna lack perfectly with the other piece. One cannot function without the other one. So to give you an example, we learn how to become women of good habits, right? Now, to become those women of good habits, we need to be motivated. To achieve anything in life, we need to be motivated. So that's what I'm saying, that by creating those good habits, and when you start seeing results, those good habits are gonna motivate you to keep moving forward. And that motivation that you have is gonna continue helping you create new habits. That's why I was telling you that the Lord gave me this image of really is a puzzle piece, the virtuous woman of today. And when you put them all together, it gives you that virtuous woman. Amen. So I want you guys to take out your Bibles. We're gonna read Isaiah 41:10. I'm gonna give you a second to pull out this scripture. I want us always to read it together. And in the meantime, I'm gonna greet you. Tamaris, I see you. God bless you. Mildred, I see you. God bless you, Bella. And if you guys are watching from anywhere, just YouTube, Facebook, I see people connected, just write down your name so I can greet you. Here on Instagram, I see Elisa, Diana, Clemente. God bless you, all of you, Nati, and all, every single one of you who are connecting. Okay, Isaiah 41:10 says, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." What is the Lord telling us here? And amen to that word. What is the Lord telling us here? That we are never alone. He's always with us. So if you are feeling alone in this process to create good habits or to become that virtuous woman of today, right? And to be able to achieve all your dreams or your goals, if sometimes you feel alone, and that creates a motivation, like that unmotivates you in your life, always remember that you're never alone. God is always with you. And He says it here in Isaiah 41:10. So I want you to type in right now in the comments, "I am never alone. God is with me." Go ahead and type it. "I'm never alone. God is with me." Because the more you declare it, the more you're gonna believe it, that you're never alone. And He's always there to support you and help you in every single decision you make, to achieve every single goal He's calling you to achieve. So you're never alone, okay? And also, I wanted to remind you ladies that motivation is one of the tools that you will need. It's the number one tool that you will need to achieve all the dreams that God is calling you to do. It's the number one tool. Remember that motivation is the number one tool that will help you to achieve everything that God is calling you to do. It is very easy, and this has happened in my life so many times, and I want you guys to type in "me too" if you agree with me, that in so many different occasions, it's so easy to get inspired, but so difficult to stay motivated. Amen? Tell me if I'm alone. Just type in "me too" if you guys agree with me. That is so easy to get inspired, but it's so difficult to get motivated. and to stay motivated. And the reason because this happens is because, as I told you at the beginning, guys, the enemy, it is not gonna let us, and his goal is not to for us to achieve everything that God is calling us to do. So he's gonna always bring discouragement. He's always gonna bring something to try to distract us and stop us from what God is calling us to do. That's why it is very important to remember that God is by our side, that he's helping us, that he's his number one goal is to help us achieve what he has called us to do. But for that, we need to remember, and this is one key that I'm giving you tonight, guys, as far as how to stay motivated, and is to remember that you're the number one cheerleader of your own dreams. Nobody, aside from God, is more interested in you, in your goals, in your dreams, in what God is asking you to do, than yourself. So anything, whatever it is that you want to accomplish in your life, whether it is to change your routines and create these new good habits that we were talking about last week, or to get a better job, or to change your diet, or to get closer to the Lord, to live a healthier life, or to organize and simplify your life, whatever dream or goal or thing you want to achieve, nobody is going to be more interested than yourself. Nobody's going to motivate you more than yourself. So always remember that you are the number one cheerleader in your life. And the Holy Spirit is always there to help you and encourage you as well to achieve everything that you were called to do. So no one is going to be more interested to change those things that God is calling you to do than yourself. And when you think about that, you actually remember and recognize that it's your responsibility to stay motivated. Amen. How many of you type in amen, understanding and agreeing with me that it's our responsibility? It's not our husbands or our brothers or our sisters or our children or our mothers or fathers to keep us motivated to achieve our dreams, but it's our own responsibility to stay motivated because we're the number one cheerleader in our life. So as a matter of fact, let's right now type in your comments, I am my best cheerleader, because you're the best cheerleader you can have. So let's go type it in. So just start remembering. Remember that the more you type in things, the more you say it aloud, the more you're going to remember it later on. And it's going to help you move on. So type in, I'm my best cheerleader. Amen. So I see you here on Instagram, Elisa, type it in. And I see you also, everybody here, Angela, Tamaris, Mildred, typing in. Praise God for that. And now, when we think about motivating ourselves, when we think about staying motivated to achieve all that God is calling us to do, it is important that we understand that everything that God is calling us to do has to do with a purpose that he has given us, with a vision that he has for our life, that every single time he encourages us, like right now, he's encouraging us all to become that virtuous woman of today. Amen. And he's encouraging us because he wants us to achieve all the potential he has given us. And if he says we can do it, then we can do it. Amen. So that should be the number one motivation. Now, if we have the best interest in our life to accomplish all that God has called us to do, the question is, why do we get discouraged and lose motivation and want to give up all the time? Am I the only one who has asked that question? Like, why, if I want to achieve something in my life, I end up being unmotivated to do it? Why is it that I don't go after whatever dream it is that I want to achieve and stay motivated until I see it complete? Why is it that I have to, fight? Like, there is this resistance, and that's precisely the reason why we feel that way. That's precisely the reason why we get unmotivated, is because we have the worst enemy of our dream, and it is resistance. Resistance immediately, when you try to achieve something, when you want to get something in your life or bring a good habit in your life as well, resistance is going to be there Always. And at the beginning, I told you, ladies, when we start working towards a dream, the first thing that comes to us is inspiration. We're inspired. You may be feeling inspired tonight to start making those changes in your life. And when you are inspired, it's so much easier to achieve things, right? But that inspiration lasts only a little bit. And then it's our responsibility to continue being staying focused and being motivated to achieve what we want to achieve. Now, one of the greatest temptations the enemy always presents us is the temptation to give up. Because during that time that we're resisting, there is an easy way out, always, to go back to our old bad habits or to, you know, start doing things that doesn't even go along with the dreams that God is asking us to do, or whatever it is that is presenting in front of us. There is always a way out, and the enemy is going to make it so appealing for us to take that path and to leave that dream, abandon that dream that God has placed in our heart. And that's why it is so important to persist. It is so important to take one step at a time, to do it little by little, and to allow God to give us that power that is in us, and start discovering, and this is what happened in my personal life, guys, to start discovering that self, that resilience that is in you, to start discovering that self-discipline that is in you. And when that only happens once you pass through that resistance. Once you say, you know what, it doesn't matter what, even though if I don't feel motivated today, I'm gonna still going to do it because I'm disciplined. And if you believe that you're a disciplined woman, you're gonna get up, you're gonna get it done. And that, with that, you're passing already that resistance. And when you pass that resistance, it's so much easier to continue being motivated. So from time to time, that resistance, that procrastination, those kind of things are gonna knock on your door. And that's when motivation, you're not gonna find it anywhere. And that's when you have to say, I am a disciplined woman and I can get it done. And that's when you're gonna start knowing yourself even deeper. Now, seeing that that dream come through is just, or seeing that dream coming through is just one step, guys, away. And it's just before you decide to quit. So the moment that you decide to quit, you're already giving up on everything and it started from the beginning. So that's why it's important that you guys remember that when resistance is coming, it's because you're getting closer to achieve that dream. And if you push through, you're getting even closer and closer. And the next thing you know is you look back and you're gonna start seeing this amazing transformation in your life. So I want you guys to declare tonight and type in the comments, I am not going to give up. Let's all come together on agreement that we are not going to give up. Whatever it is that we started doing here, this class, learning how to become a virtuous woman and applying everything that God is calling us to do, we're not gonna give up. So write it down, I am not going to give up, and let's believe that God is gonna help us through the process and that we're gonna be able to see ourselves successful at the end of the journey. Remember that the moment you quit, you could have been one step away from becoming the virtuous woman, from achieving that dream that you wanted to achieve. So just keep pushing. Amen. Now, remember the promise that God made you, and that is that He will be with you wherever you go. And I'm going to tell you why, guys, because God anoints and His presence, and that's what that word means, is with you guys whenever He calls you to do something. At this moment, the Word of God is telling us that we're the virtuous woman. Amen. And we believe it. We declare it. We say, yes, Lord, all those characteristics of the virtuous woman is within me. I just need to activate them. I just need to practice on them. I just need to make them stronger every single day. But He calls us to do this. And when He calls us to do something, His presence is with us. And when His presence is with us, He helps us through the process. Amen. So the Lord, when He sends us to do something, He also equips us and He aligns everything around your life so it supports what He's calling you to do. And when you understand this, when you understand that God is by your side, that He's helping you, that He's supporting you on the decision you have made, then it's so much easier to stay motivated because you know that you're not alone. And that's the scripture we read at the beginning. That's the number one motivation we have in our life, knowing that the Creator is with us all the time. And then while you do the natural, when you're focusing on doing what God is calling you to do, God is helping you with the supernatural. He's giving you that strength that you need, the wisdom that you need. If you are declaring that you're a self-disciplined woman, He's going to activate that in you so you can work. You just need to believe it. Amen. So the more you work on those kind of things and you know the word of God and you do your part, God will start doing His part in your life. Now, God's timing, and this is so critical for us to understand, that God's timing is not the same as ours. Don't get discouraged when you don't see things happening quickly or when you were expecting it to happen, because His timing is better than ours. Amen. And when we rely on the Lord, when we wait on Him, on His perfect timing, we see that His plans were definitely better than ours. That's why when things don't happen the way you were expecting or at the time you were expecting, if you have already prayed, if you have already left everything, like in this case, we want to become the virtuous woman, right? So we're asking God to help us in the process. And it will be at His timing. As long as I'm doing my natural, my part, God will do His supernatural at His perfect time for me to be able to see that come to pass. But in the meantime, I'm going to stay motivated. And I want you guys to go to the Bible and read Jeremiah 29:11. And let's read this scripture because it is going to remind you the perfect plans that God has for you. And if you guys always remember and actually cling on this scripture, you guys are going to be motivated no matter what you're doing, no matter where you're going, because you know God's plan is better than yours. Amen. So it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." So what we're doing here tonight, we're learning practical steps. We're learning how to stay motivated. We're learning how to create good habits in our life. We're learning all those pieces that God is giving us, puzzle pieces to build the virtuous woman of today that is in us. And that's us doing our natural part. Now we have to wait on the Lord to do His supernatural to achieve even more than what we were expecting. So I want you guys to type in on the comments, God's timing is perfect. Because this is going to help you remember that as long as you're doing your natural part, you can stay motivated to keep going, because God in the meantime is working something deep in you. Transforming something deep in you, aligning everything around you, so whatever He's calling you to do, you can see it come to pass. Amen? So let's type in, God's timing is perfect. Declare it every single day. When you get discouraged, when you get, you don't know what to do, you don't know why things are not coming the way you want to do it, remember that God's timing is perfect. Now, who is responsible for keep you motivating, for motivating you? Who is responsible? Remind me, you. You are responsible. I am responsible for my own motivation, on my goals, on the things that God is calling me to do. You are responsible for your own motivation. Amen. So the more you remember that, the more you're going to stop relying on other people to motivate you, to encourage you, and the more you're going to start relying on yourself, on the Lord. Amen. Because you guys are a team. You guys are working together. He is your number one cheerleader, and you are your number one cheerleader. So when you guys put yourself together, the Lord and you, you guys will achieve amazing things together. You doing the natural, the Lord doing the supernatural. Amen. Now, very quickly, I want to tell you ladies that this motivation, this piece, this puzzle piece is so important for everything we're going to be learning throughout the book. It's so important. It's one of the most important pieces, because motivation is what is attacked the most by the enemy for us to drop everything. So we're going to divide this chapter into four classes. So this is class one. This is part one of four on how to stay motivated, because it is important that you guys understand this important thing. But I'm going to give you today, and I'm going to leave you with one step that is going to help you tremendously to stay motivated. And tomorrow on the workshop with Angelica, you guys are gonna be able to go deeply into this, and she's gonna share with you some scriptures that are gonna help you as well to stay motivated, scriptures that actually helped me in my personal life to stay motivated when it got rough in my life, and that it still helps me when I want to quit, when I get resistance. Those scriptures really help me. So they are in the book if you have it. If you don't have it, tomorrow Angelica is going to give it to you during the workshop. Amen. But that first step to stay motivated is to keep your spirit well fed. That's the number one step. Because in order for you to stay motivated on the physical, on the natural, it is important that you actually stay motivated on the spiritual, in your spiritual life. Your spirit is what's going to give you that strength, that motivation, that discipline. When the motivation, the natural motivation is missing, is the one that's going to help you achieve everything that God is calling you to do. So keep your spirit well fed. And for that, we need to read the Word of God every day. We need to make a list of all God's promises in our life. We need to memorize verses of that fills you with peace, with motivation, with joy, with faith. So all those scriptures that encourage you, it's important that you memorize them. So for those days that you feel unmotivated, you can cling on those scriptures. You can actually reach out and seek out to God and say, you know what, the Word of God says this, and this is what I'm going to believe, this is what I'm going to stand by for, and I'm going to believe what God is telling me here, and I'm going to declare it. And those, on those days that you don't feel motivated, those scriptures will actually will lift you up, and it will help you achieve everything that God is calling you to do. Now, keep in mind, guys, that the Word of God is powerful. It is so powerful that I have seen it in my own life when I feel the worst, when the day is cloudy, it's raining, it's cold, any excuse I can give to not work out or to not eat healthy or to not do everything that God is calling me to do, right? And I just want to be on my PJs all day, sleeping, eating pizza, right? And not doing anything. On those days, when resistance is coming to do whatever God is calling me to do and to incorporate those good habits in my life, the only thing that has helped me and pushed me through to actually accomplish what I need to accomplish has been the Word of God, has been those scriptures that I have been memorizing for moments like that. When I, for example, that scripture that I gave you, that you are self-disciplined. It is in you. And when you say it, when you believe it, you're actually able to get up and do the things that God has called you to do. So if I can do it, my love, you can do it as well. I know it's in you, and I know you can do it too. And that's the number one thing I'm going to be giving you during the next 3 weeks, more steps, practical steps that you can do to stay motivated. So the enemy, when he tries to come and attacks and bring resistance, you can fight back. So I'm going to give you more, but this is the number one and one of the most important ones. So I want you to meditate on that this week. And I want you, to, you guys to make sure you join tomorrow on the workshop, because once again, with Angelica, you guys are going to go deeper into this. You guys are going to activate this step. You guys are going to find those scriptures and go deeper in those scriptures that will help you with that. And if you guys cannot connect, remember that it's already on the book. Those scriptures are there. And if you need the link to connect tomorrow with Angelica, just send me a DM and I will be more than happy to send you the link. And how many of you are excited to activate this second puzzle piece that we are learning, and we're going to be learning this for the next 3 weeks? How many of you just write me? I'm excited. I want to activate that second piece, that second puzzle piece. Because as I said, guys, little by little, as we put those pieces together, we are going to be able to see that virtuous woman come out. And we're going to realize that there were so many things in us that we didn't even know that are going to start coming out And we're going to be so excited because a lot of people are looking for the purpose, for their calling, for, you know, what it is, but God won't be able to give it to you until you're ready. And I discovered that in my own life. It wasn't until I was able to maintain what God was planning to give me, and that was by activating these pieces of the virtuous woman, He wasn't able to call me into ministry or do, be able to do and achieve everything that He has called me to do. So I am so excited, ladies, for each of one of you, knowing that you guys are going to activate that virtuous woman, knowing that you guys are going to be able to start discovering so many things about yourself, about the power that God has given you, and not just that, but achieving everything that He has called you to do and He has created you to be. Amen. So that being said, I remind you to turn on notifications on Facebook, on Instagram, on YouTube, so you guys can get that notification when we go live with these classes, so you guys don't forget. It sends you reminders as well, so turn on those notifications. Make sure you give a like to this video. Make sure you share it. Invite other ladies, other friends to these classes, because the whole point is to be able to spread this blessing to other people. So if you're being blessed by these classes, think about somebody you can also invite and send them the link and encourage them to be part of these classes. Don't forget to tune in tomorrow to the workshop so you guys can activate this piece. And if you guys are taking pictures or sharing things online, make sure you use the hashtag The Virtuous Woman. Tag me on it so I can share with my audience what you guys are doing and what you guys are going through. I'm so excited about this. And that being all, my loves, let me pray, close in prayer, and ask that God help us to stay motivated this week and to help us activate this peace in our life. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for tonight. Thank you for the word of encouragement you have given us today, tonight. Thank you, Father, because we know you're guiding every single step, because we know, Father, that with you, we're able to accomplish everything you're calling us to do. Thank you for reminding us that we're not alone in this journey and that you are going to help us, Lord, activate this piece of motivation in our life, of self-discipline in our life. Thank you, Father, for everything you're doing in our life. Thank you for activating that virtuous woman in us. And thank you, Lord, because even though we say goodbye tonight, we know your presence is always with us. Thank you, Lord. And we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Okay, my loves, it has been a pleasure being here with all of you. Thank you so much for connecting. And I'll see you guys next week. God bless you. Bye, guys.